Welcome to the tutorial for data paging in Content Studio. This video explains the concept of paging and demonstrates how to use the feature using a Data Studio source. Data paging requires Display Studio version 3.0 or higher. Data sources eligible for paging include JSON and Excel file types that are configured using Daktronics Data Studio. An easy way to determine if the source can be paged is if it's organized into a collapsible hierarchy like the one pictured here in the Dynamic Data Library. Data paging is a concept that allows a single data field or bounding box in Content Studio to display multiple fields from the data source, reducing the number of fields needed to show the complete set of information. In this video, we will use basketball team standings as an example. With the traditional method, creating scrolling standings content using RTD requires 90 different data fields. To be legible in the desired font size, this would require 3 different layouts timed in Content Studio, or 3 different VMPF files played in a Display Studio playlist button. Data paging requires only 2 data fields placed on the canvas. Since we will use 6 different data types in this example, we will need 6 data fields. Content Studio replicates them into a list of 5 teams on the screen at a time. Paging then updates the data 3 times, totaling 90 RTD fields. To use data paging, place the first set of information onto the canvas from the Dynamic Data Library. Set the desired font settings to the first set of data. With the set of data selected, choose Create Record from the Data List tab in Content Studio. A drop-down will appear and will vary based on how the data source is organized. Select the level within the data for which you'd like the data to page through. In this example, we will be paging through the 15 teams in the conference. In the List section, select the orientation in which the list should be displayed, either vertically or horizontally. Click the plus sign next to Records Displayed to begin creating the remaining items in the list. Items will be added using the same font formatting as the first item. Since there are 15 teams in the conference, we will choose to show them in 3 pages of 5. The larger bounding box around the set of data may be used to move the data around the layout as a single item. Once the 5 teams are on the layout, select them all and choose Page Records. Enter the desired hold time for how long the list should hold prior to advancing to the next page. Change the layout time to evenly distribute all paging elements. Because we have 3 sets of teams paging for 5 seconds each, we will make the layout time 15 seconds. Save the file and script a button to play the content using Display Studio. DMP8000 plays the layout and the data within pages at the rate determined in the hold time. This concludes the tutorial for data paging in Content Studio. Visit other videos on the Daktronics Systems YouTube channel for more information.